Hey guys, it's Andy. So anybody that's unbelievable at sales is incredible at asking the right questions. We all know this. The guy that asks the best questions is the guy that's going to be deadly during negotiations and is the guy that finds out enough about their customer that they can remember to remember what they hear through the entire sell so they can always close their customer. If you want to become one of the best salespeople in the country, you have to learn how to ask great questions. During this video, you're going to learn how 9 different ways to ask questions during the sell. Hey guys, how you doing? It's Andy Elliott. All right, so check this out. This is going to be a video that I've never done before, and it's going to be based off asking questions. Now, I'm specifically going to talk about questions during negotiations, but I want to talk about asking questions. I honestly believe that there is a lot of times when somebody could have closed a sale had they have asked the right questions up front. I always know this. If you ask great questions, you get great answers. When you get great answers, you find out what you want to hear, and guess what? It's easier to close the sale. So if you want to be a high achiever and you want to become deadly at negotiating, one of the things that I commonly like to teach is how to be great at asking the right questions. Have you ever heard your managers say, well, did you ask them the right questions? What questions did you ask them? Hey, did you ask them about this? I'm going to tell you this. I'm going to go over 9 types of questions and how the different way are that you can ask them. Also, I'm going to go over the 5 different ways that you can actually ask those questions. So there are 5 different ways you can actually ask them. And to make this easy, because I honestly felt like getting into question asking, you're going to have a lot of people, and this may be you, it may be me. I was always good at being a visual person. I like to watch a video on training. I also like to read and watch a download. So I've created a PDF file. It's going to be a free download over explaining exactly what these type of 9 questions are to use during negotiations. All you got to do is click the link below. Just click on it right now, okay? And you're going to see a little link. When you click on it, it's got these 9 types of questions. And what I did is I actually typed out exactly what each type of question means. So if I don't cover it all the way in the video, you can actually learn it word for word. You can read it, highlight it. Man, it's a worksheet. Tear it up. It doesn't matter. But actually use it as a training sheet, okay? So download that. It's free, and that's kind of the easiest way for me to let you really read this stuff while I make a quick video about the 9 types of questions. All right, so number 1. Hey guys, I see you. Listen, I appreciate you. Sorry for interrupting the video. I just wanted to tell you real quick, please do me a favor. Comment below. Let me know what you're struggling with. Let me know what you think about the video. I reply to every single one of my comments. I'm here to help you. And by the way, please like the video, subscribe, share it with a friend. Let's get back to the video. Best types of questions to ask during negotiations, obviously, is going to be an open-ended question. If you don't know what an open-ended question is, like I said, download the PDF. It'll explain to you what it is. I'm going to move through these kind of quick, and I want you to think about what ones you're familiar with and what ones you're not familiar with. Okay? Open opportunity questions are great. Leading questions are probably my favorite. These are the ones right here during negotiations that you can lead your customer straight to a close. I'll show you how to do it, and I put examples in the PDF. So low-key questions are great. Sequential questions, they're always awesome. Flattery questions, I got probing deeper questions. This is probably one of the ones right here that I use early on during a negotiation, which allows me to really feel my customer out where they're at. It's my job as, I would say, seller management, right? To manage my customer that's buying the vehicle. And there's a little emotional thermometer question that I have built in that allows me to kind of test where they're at and obviously tell whether I need to pick up my game or whether I'm in the right zone. And then landmine questions. These 9 types of questions right here, I didn't specifically put in what type of question you could ask. A great question would be ask great question, get great answers. I'd be say, oh, okay, cool. So are you guys trading this in? They say, yeah. I say, okay, awesome. And then, you know, so how long have you owned it? Well, we've owned it for about 3 years. Awesome. Did you purchase it brand new? Yeah, we did. Awesome. You know what? These are really nice vehicles. So was this the specific package that you wanted to buy when you bought it? Or was there anything that you were missing that you really wanted? Well, Andy, you know, we wanted leather, but it was a little out of our price range. Okay, cool, man. I love it. So, and that may be just questions that I'm asking about gathering thoughts. I may even ask him this if you're testing, like maybe, I don't know, qualify like budget questions and stuff like that. I may say, okay, cool. So who is your car financed with currently? And they say, it's financed with, I don't know, Ally Finance. I say, oh, okay, cool, man. So roughly what's your payment ballpark on it? 360. Wow, how'd you get it so low? That's a question. Watch. Wow, how'd you get it so low? they say, wow, we really didn't think it was that low. And I say, oh, yeah, it's a pretty low payment. That's me just checking them. You see that? That's an emotional thermometer question. I'm checking them to see how they feel about the payment range. I don't even have to ask them where they want to be to ask them when they say whatever their payment is. I say, wow, how'd you get it so low? And they're like, well, we actually put $5,000 down. Well, man, I'm glad I asked that question, because during negotiations, I can say, hey, so we were talking outside earlier on the lot, and you were telling me how last time you put $5,000 down, that's how you really helped get your payment low. The fact that you're not putting any money down, you can understand with no money down, your payment's going to be higher. It's like a teeter-totter, right? Look, asking great questions will allow you to set yourself up in the sell later on, okay? I want to explain to you the different kinds of questions that there are. I want you to become familiar with them, and it's not that you have to fall in love with all nine of them. I want you to find two or three that you enjoy using, and that way when you're selling and you're negotiating, yes, you know all nine of them and kind of know how to use it, but you really can find your favorite ones that you want to use as you're trying to advance the sell forward and close it up. All right, let's move over here to this side real quick. So these are the five ways that you can ask the question. And I'm also going over this as well in the PDF. There's aggressive questions, which sometimes need to be asked, okay? Not all the time, they're not my favorite, but they're aggressive questions, loaded questions, emotional questions, impulsive questions, and trickery questions. These five are the best way to ask while you're using these type of nine questions. You may say, Andy, all right, I'm a little bit confused right now. Look, here's what I'm explaining to you. You don't have to be confused. Just like I gave the example a minute ago, how I'd qualify somebody on a car, and I obviously don't have to do that full qualification on that customer, but I have more questions to ask if I need to get information. And by asking a customer a simple question, which would be, how did you get your payment so low? Guess what? That allows me to hear the response that they're going to give me. It's not an offensive question. I say, wow, how'd you get your payment so low? They say, well, I mean, I didn't really think it was that low. Yeah, it's a pretty low payment. It really is. And then I can hear what they're going to say after that, or they might have come back and said, well, we put $10,000 down when we bought it, or we have a paid off trade. I say, well, how'd you get your payment so low? You must have had a lot of cash down when you bought it. No, we really didn't have any money down. Wow, that's a pretty good payment, man. You know what? I want to hear what they're going to say. That little quote doesn't mean anything. It's just for my ears to understand where my customer's at. Now, I want to share with you at the end of the day, ask great questions, get great answers. Closing and negotiation is about finding out information. People have things that are going on inside of their head. It's your goal to figure out what exactly that is that's going on inside of their head, right? And then do what? Finish the sentence that's going on in their head. When you finish the sentence, the sell is made. They're like, wow, man, I've got this feeling inside that I'm in the right place and this is the right car for me. Because you did what? You found out more information than the guy across the street, right? So guess what you do? You have to be deadly at asking questions. So guys, this is kind of a quicker video. I feel like a lot of people have been asking me, Andy, what kind of questions do I ask during negotiations? What kind of questions do I ask on the lot? I've got lots of Fact, Find, Qualify videos. We have the 0 to 100K course. You can dive into that. That'll teach you, the millions of ways to ask questions and the specific questions to ask. This is really just about what types of questions that you can ask. So download it below, check it out, read over it really well. And then at the end of the day, if you have any questions, you can always text me. I'd be happy to help you. 918-210-0254. You guys have a blessed day. Crush it, kill it, man. I'll see you guys soon. Hey guys, number one, thank you so much for watching the entire video. You guys are awesome. I'm grateful for you. If it wasn't for you, I wouldn't have my training program. So I thank you, I thank you, and I thank you. I got three things for you real quick. Number one, shoot me a text message. If I haven't met you, I would love to. My phone number is 918-210-0254. Shoot me a text. I'd love to meet you. Secondly, go to Facebook. Join Andy Elliott Car Sales Nation. That's Andy Elliott Car Sales Nation. One of the best Facebook groups in the world, hands down, for automotive sales training. And then lastly, I've got over 500 videos on YouTube, guys. Keep up the training. Keep watching the videos and crush it.